The vision processing for FPGA video series to this point shows how to implement a lane detection algorithm in hardware, focusing only on the hardware side, sending out lane coordinates for the software to act upon. This video will show a simple path to prototyping the hardware and software together on a Xilinx Zynq device on an Avnet Pico Z embedded vision kit, with the software simply overlaying the lane boundaries. To get started, you will need to download and install the Computer Vision System Toolbox support package for Xilinx Zynq based hardware. This video here walks you through that process. Once that's set up, the lane detection design has been modified a bit for hardware-software targeting. The source input is no longer MATLAB code driving a workspace variable. Here it's set up all in Simulink to choose between a preloaded video file and the live feed from the HDMI camera. Right now it's set to use the file. Then the video frames get converted to a stream of pixels with control signals, and the hardware design is also the same as before, with one exception. There's this control interface block that coordinates between the hardware and software. This buffers the individual lane coordinates that stream out of the hardware into vectors for the left and right lane coordinates for each frame. Also for this demo, we take the bird's eye view and extract out a 640 by 480 region to send to the software, where we will overlay the lane markings for display. Looking inside the software partition, we have a controller that corresponds to the one on the hardware side, which controls when the lane fit takes the set of coordinates from the hardware. This function performs ransack fitting to create a second order polynomial equation to model the curved line for each lane from each set of coordinates. Then each lane gets overlaid on the bird's eye frame that's sent out from the hardware. The hardware is running at 25.2 MHz. This accommodates the number of pixels for a full image frame with the horizontal and vertical blanking with intensity color map at 60 frames per second. I'm going to kick off a simulation to show it running, but one of the nice aspects of this hardware support package is the ability to simulate at different levels. I just started a system modeling simulation, which is all in Simulink using a video file. Once you have your hardware and software implementation models, you can use HDL Coder and Embedded Coder to target the FPGA and processor on a system-on-chip device. After the simulation finishes, we'll move on to prototyping. And you can see the simulation results slowly coming out now with the polynomial fit overlay lines. Before we get to targeting, the way the hardware and software communicate with each other is through memory mapped registers, which are memory locations with predetermined addresses. HDL Coder's IP core generation workflow lets you assign the hardware I/O to either pins on the chip or to the Zynq AXI registers. Each device board combination has specific pin configurations and memory map addresses. These are defined in what's called a reference design, which your hardware algorithm will plug into. The reference design for this kit is all set up as part of the hardware support package. Now for targeting, we'll use the HDL workflow advisor. The hardware support package sets this all up automatically. Here's where the hardware IOs are assigned to registers or pins. And from here, we can then automatically create the Vivado project and the driver models that the software side will need in order to communicate with the hardware. Generating the bitstream takes a while, so we can set up the software model. HDL Coder's IP core generation creates two libraries and template designs to use them. One is for the software drivers to communicate with the hardware, and we'll focus on that one. We can take the generated template model and populate it with the software algorithm. It looks like it's talking to the lane detection algorithm here, but it's really just calling these AXI drivers. This model is what we'll use to program the ARM using Embedded Coder. To program this to the ARM, you'll need to make sure you have the Embedded Coder support package installed and properly set up for targeting a connected Zynq device. Then you just make sure your configuration parameters are set correctly for targeting the Zynq, then you can deploy to hardware. And here's our prototype running on the board in the lab. We're feeding in the recorded video file since we're not driving down the road, and we're viewing the output in Simulink. But the hardware and software algorithms are running on the board, which is why the output video is now real time. So this was a quick overview of some of the considerations you need to make when prototyping a hardware-software video processing application. The Vision Zynq hardware support package is a great way to get started with this.